Hey, it's Ross from rossluckman.com. Today is part two of my series on the Seamarine Pico battery monitoring system. In part one, we set it up as a battery monitor with the SC503 shunt. We programmed it in, updated the firmware, and we also went over the Seamarine system and looked at all the different modules that you can get, as this system is very expandable. And that is what we're going to be doing today. We're going to be expanding it beyond just a battery monitor and adding the SCQ50 Quadro shunt. This is one of three Quadro shunts that Seamarine has. This particular one has four 50 amp shunts, so we can measure chargers or loads. So whether the power is coming or going into or out of our system, we can measure those chargers like solar or consumers like a 12 volt refrigerator. Now, speaking of 12 volts, this system can do 12 or 24 volts. The shunts are really made to measure up to 35 volts. And this Quadro shunt has a little alarm relay there. We can program it to go off with various parameters such as battery state of charge. Maybe the battery gets down to 20% and we want to set off that relay and turn on the vehicle's engine, something like that. So all of the Quadro shunts have that relay built in. Now they also have an SCQ25 that has 25 amp shunts if you have smaller consumers where you don't need the full 50 amps running through there. I have a charger that's a little bit bigger that we're going to be running through here, so I have the SCQ50 for today's demonstration. Now they have a combo shunt, the SCQ25T, so it's got the 25 amp shunts, four of them. And then it has the alarm, or excuse me, inputs for voltage or resistive based senders or temperature sensors. So you can measure temperature or your water tank levels, as well as those chargers and consumers through the Quadro shunt portion. And this one also comes with the alarm relay. So very versatile item. We're gonna go ahead and go with the SCQ50 for today, because we are just going to be measuring the chargers and loads. We're going to program it into the Pico and take a look at that real-time data as those chargers and loads run through our system. So it should be a pretty cool video. Now, before we set up our demonstration board here, if you're interested in your overall power system, not just your monitoring, but things like solar, shore, and alternator power, I have a resource that you may be interested in called the Ultimate Van Power Cheat Sheet. It's got a discussion of those three major charging sources, solar, shore, and alternator power. It's going to talk about how they each have strengths, but they each also have kind of a weakness or a blind spot. But when you bring them together and they work together in a holistic power strategy, it's going to make sure that you have a good charge source no matter where you go out on the road, so you can enjoy what you're doing out there and you're not going to be worried about running out of power. There's also a discussion on different battery chemistries and the strengths and weaknesses of those. That's going to help you narrow in on which battery type is going to be right for you. And there's also a diagram that's essentially your whole power system on one page. It's going to show the three major charging sources at the top and how they make their way through the system, how that power comes in, charges your batteries, and makes its way to your end devices such as your microwave or your phone charger. So it's a really cool diagram that you'll probably find useful. To get your own copy of the Ultimate Van Power Cheat Sheet, all you have to do is click that link below or go to rossluckman.com/vanpower. With that, let's kick it off, and we are going to add our Quadro shunt to the board and run some chargers and loads through it and take a look. Thank you. All right, we've got the Quadrashunt on the board. We've got four items running through it. And before we get into the programming of it in the Pico, let's talk about what's on the board. So first off, we have chargers and loads over here on the left. At the top, we have a 30 amp charger. We next have a 12 volt refrigerator, which is down on the floor. I'll show you that in just a sec. We've got a 12 volt water pump and a 12 volt puck light. So I wanted us to have a variety of items to take our measurements here on the Pico. And the other thing that I wanted to show is the Quadrashunt is actually upside down, or the labels are upside down. This side says in and this side says out. And the way that Seamarine wants us to do this is the inside is supposed to go into the battery and the outside is supposed to go to the chargers and loads. So I followed directions on that, flipped it upside down. Now, as far as the data cable, that's running over to the splitter. The splitter is where all of your modules are going to connect, and then that's going to send one cord or one line to the back of the Pico to report the data from all those modules. Now, these modules are daisy chainable, so I could have put that data cable from the Quadrashunt down to this shunt and then this shunt to the splitter. So you can just put those in a daisy chain and have quite a few modules all reporting back to the splitter and then back to the Pico. Now, the other thing to note on the board is the fuse block here. I've taken all the fuses out and we're going to use that as kind of a switchboard so I can add the fuse and turn these different appliances on. That way I didn't have to add switches for our demonstration, but we can add the fuses one at a time to turn those different loads on. With the charger, I'll just plug it into the wall to turn it on, and it has its own onboard fuse. But that is kind of our setup. Let me show you the refrigerator just so you have a full picture. This is an isotherm drawer fridge. I really like the drawer fridges. It just seems a lot more convenient than having to bend down to the floor to get your items. It's a little bit more expensive, but I think they're a good option. But we've got a variety of items running through the shunt. And once we put those fuses in, our consumers will turn on. So at this point, we need to get into the Pico itself. Now, I wanted to give a detail on how we're going to program it and how we're going to connect the Seamarine app on our smartphone to the Pico. So in video one, we set the Pico up as what you call an access point, or AP, and it's going to put out its own Wi-Fi signal, and we just get on that signal with our smartphone. However, I had to take my smartphone off of the Wi-Fi that's in the room, and that's kind of inconvenient because I've got to switch the Wi-Fi signal or switch the Wi-Fi network. What we want to do is switch this to STA, which is station. That's the other Wi-Fi protocol. And in that configuration, the Pico will connect to the Wi-Fi in the room. Your phone connects to that same Wi-Fi network, and they'll run through your Wi-Fi router to talk to each other. So that's the first thing we're going to do on the programming is set that up. And then I'm actually going to use the phone to rename each of these little shunts. It's a little easier to do on the phone because you have that full keyboard instead of just the up and down arrow keys on the Pico. So let's jump into the Pico here. We'll set up the Wi-Fi and then we'll get on the smartphone and complete the programming. So here we are at the main screen on the Pico. Let's take a look at the Wi-Fi settings and I'll show you the two different ways you can set that up. So we're going to hit the circle button on the bottom right. Hold that down to go into settings. Scroll down to where it says Wi-Fi. Click the circle button and you can see it says AP on the mode. So that's access point. You can see the Pico itself is putting out this Pico 8429 Wi-Fi network. So our smartphone would be able to pick up that Wi-Fi signal. But as I said, it's a little bit limiting. So if you have a Wi-Fi router in the room with your Pico, what we're going to do is we're going to go down to the mode. We're going to click the circle button and we're going to change it to STA for station. Hold down the circle button and it's going to convert over to STA. And at this point, it's going to look for Wi-Fi router signals that are in the room. Now I've already set mine up, so it's located my router, but what you would do is you would go to SSID, click the circle button, and it's going to scan for any Wi-Fi signals that it can find. It's going to pull up all signals, and you're just going to scroll down to your particular Wi-Fi router and click the circle button to confirm. Mine's already set up, so I'm gonna hit the back key. We're good to go, and now we need to go into the smartphone, and we're going to do some programming on the Quadro Shunt. So here we are on the phone, and I wanted to show you the Wi-Fi network the phone's connected to is the same one as the Pico, so they should be able to talk to each other. At this point, let's open the C-Marine app. And you can see it has connected to the Pico. It's gonna pull up all of Pico's data. You wanna make sure the Pico has not fallen asleep as well. It may turn off after 5 minutes. So turn it back on. The phone is gonna pull in all that data. What we need to do is, and this is the setup from video one. So this is our main shunt and our main battery setup that we set up previously. What we're gonna do is go click the gear icon in the top right, and we're gonna go to devices. And you can see at the bottom, we have our Quadro Shunt 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we have our alarm relay there at the very bottom. You can see this was all set up. This is the 500 amp shunt set up in video one, and it's attributed to battery number one. So with the Quadro Shunt, we can attribute these shunts to a particular battery. We can assign them, or we can have them be independent shunts that are just going to give us a measurement of a particular charger or load. So I set up battery number two as kind of a demo here. Let's click on battery two, and it doesn't have any shunts attributed to it yet. So if we click on shunts, you can see the Quadro Shunt shunts are all available, and we can toggle these on and tell it to tie any or all of those shunts to battery two. So basically it's going to say these currents are coming in or out of battery number two. We don't really want to do that in this demo. We're going to have these be independent measurements. So I'm going to back out of that, but I just wanted to show you that particular option. Let's go down, and what we want to do is name these. That's the main thing I'm going to do in the smartphone is name them. So shunt number one is going to say charger. On the range, basically you want to match the range to the item. So the charger is 30 amps, so we could match, say the range is 30 amps for this particular shunt. I'm going to do that in the Pico itself and show you graphically what that means. Reverse is basically if you need to reverse the reading going through that shunt. So it might say 30 amps and you have it backwards and you want to reverse the readout and have it say negative 30 amps. You can leave the wiring the same, and the Pico can change the number that it's displaying. It's going to be the same number. It's just going to go from positive to negative or vice versa. We're going to leave that alone because we have it wired how we want it. Add current is where we can add the current of all the shunts together and attribute them, like I said, to a particular battery. In our case, we're going to not add them to a battery or add them together. We're just going to have them be each individual measurements of individual items. So I'm going to turn that off. That's going to be the case for all four shunts. I'm going to turn that off for all of them. As far as the battery, if we had tied this shunt to battery two, that would show up here. And display priority is how high on the Pico screen do you want this particular shunt reading to show up. We're gonna leave that to high for all of them. I'm gonna click save settings. Let's move on to the second one and do, what is that one? That is our fridge. So we're gonna come in here and call that fridge. A lot faster to name these on the smartphone. The range I'm going to leave alone, we'll adjust that later. I'm going to turn off the add current, click save. Number three is going to be the pump. All right, turn that off, click save. Number four is going to be the light. Turn that off and click save. So if we go down to the bottom, you can see they've all been renamed. The digital output, the alarm relay, it'll show up and give you some parameters, but we really can't change anything. We're gonna leave that alone. But now if we show up the amp meters here on the bottom, I don't know if you can read that, But you can see those are our four shunts, charger, fridge, pump, and light. Everything's off, so they all read 0 amps. But at this point, let's go ahead and go back to the Pico itself, and we'll turn on our chargers and loads and take a look. All right, so here we are back at the Pico, and I have put in the fuse for the fridge. I'm trying to run my battery down a little bit so we can get the charger to come on at full blast. But as you can see with the fridge, it's reading 4.5 amps about, and it's way down on the graphical interface. So what we wanna do is change the range. This is where range comes in. Maybe we put 6 amps as the range, and so it'll actually show up on the bar and look like something. So we'll hit the circle button to go into settings. We'll go down to devices, current sensors, and we will go to the fridge. Range is set at 100, and we'll run it down to 6 amps. Click the circle button to confirm. We'll back out of there, and let's take a look. So there you go. So you can see that it's now showing up as something, and we can see that that item is actually on. Let's do the same thing with the light. So I plugged in the fuse for the light. You can see it's barely showing up as anything. 0.12 amps there at the bottom. You can't even see it. So let's change the range to 1 amp for that. We're gonna go back to devices, back to current sensors, go down to the light, and you can see it's set at 100. Let's bring it down to 1 amp. Click the circle button to confirm. Let's go back out and take a look. All right, so now it's kind of showing up a little bit there. The pump, let's put in our fuse, take a reading. Gonna be kind of loud. Now the pump is not connected to any water line, so it's not gonna be pumping up to 60 PSI or any kind of pressure, so it may not be taking as much power as it would, but let's see, 1.12. I'm gonna pull the fuse so it's not too annoying there. Let's go in, it was 1.12 amps. Let's change the pump to a range of 2 amps. Click to confirm, let's go back out and we will put that fuse back in. All right, there it is, it's showing up as something. But not for long. Don't wanna listen to that thing. All right, so what we're gonna do is now do the charger, and hopefully it'll go into bulk mode and put out a full 30 amps and we'll take a look. All right, for the time being, we have the charger at just about 30 amps. Let's change the range. So it has a default 100 amp range, and let's say 31 amps would be our range. Click to confirm. Hit the back arrow to get out. And you can see the charger, it's now gone into absorption mode, so it's going to slowly deplete that current as the battery's pretty much full. But you can see it's showing up. Changing the range gets them to show up in a meaningful way on the interface here. Now, I wanted to show you something that I discovered. If you look at the charger, it's got a negative number. So the way I attribute these shunts is, if it's a negative number, it's like a bank account, it's like a debit. So the charger is actually putting a positive deposit into our system. It's not negative. So what we can do is reverse that reading. So we'll go to reverse current. We saw this in the smartphone app, but it's also here on the Pico. We're gonna say reverse the current on the charger, and you're gonna see it's gonna go from orange to blue. So we've reversed it, let's take a look. So it's now blue, and we want our consumers to be negative numbers. They're pulling power out of the system. So even if we're not attributing these shunts to a particular battery, it's good to have your chargers be a positive current and your loads be a negative current. It just makes sense from a bank account analogy standpoint. So let's go in and change the fridge should be a negative number. Let's reverse that current. Well, you can see if we go and look at the fridge, it's now negative, and it should show as orange instead of blue. So you can think of the chargers are blue. It's peaceful. They're charging up your system. The orange is things that are draining your system. So it's things you want to look out for. Maybe that's one way to look at it. Let's change the last two. So you can see those are reversed now. If we turn on the pump momentarily, that's now a reverse or a negative number as well. So this is as it should be. Our lows are negative and our charger is positive. And what's kind of cool is you can see the main shunt there, the battery shunt that we set up in the last video, it's still taking a reading, and it's basically the balance of all these shunts should add up to the reading on that main battery shunt. Lastly, I wanted to show you one more thing. If we go into just the charger, I wanted to show you the other parameters there. So if we click on name, you can change the name in the Pico. I would recommend using the smartphone app. Change the range. We can reverse the current. We can add the current. Remember, we saw that in the smartphone app. We can add the currents together. We can attribute this to a battery. We avoided doing that. Display separately. We can display it on a separate screen of the Pico. Display priority. We can change that here. The device is the SEQ50 input 1. That's the serial number. We can merge this shunt number 1 with one of the other shunts. So let's say we're on the charger, we can merge it with the light. If we want those two shunts to be measured as one item. So said differently, four 50 amp shunts could be added together to make a 200 amp shunt, essentially, with four lines running through it. But to the Pico, it would add all of those shunts together, all of those readings, and give you one number. But that is a little bit more info on how to set things up in the Pico. And you can see this is just one of the screens. That's the main screen. And there is the quadro shunt readings. You can see our battery 2 that we never set up. But you're just going to scroll through, and these will show up on one of the screens of the Pico. That's my video on the Seamarine Quadro Shunt. This is definitely a very interesting device that's going to give you some next level data about what's going on in your power system, where that power is going to or coming from. So I hope that was useful for you. Again, if you want more information on your overall power system, you got to grab a copy of the Ultimate Van Power Cheat Sheet. Just click that link below or go to rosslukeman.com/vanpower. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.